गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस लेक्चर ऑफ पावर सिस्टम इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एज पर आवर एस यू करिकुलम। द कोड नंबर इज 3311। डबल इज डिनोटिंग फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग यूनिट इज द फिफ्थ। वी आर स्टार्टेड बेसिकली एंड द टॉपिक इज पावर सिस्टम इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन सेकेंड। इन दिस फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द इंस्ट्रूमेंट ट्रांसफॉर्मर्स। वॉट आर द इंस्ट्रूमेंट ट्रांसफॉर्मर्स वी हैव? वी कैन सी इंस्ट्रूमेंट ट्रांसफॉर्मर्स। So we are going to understand this whole thing. Now, if I am talking about the power system instrumentation, so as I earlier told you, my dear student, that power system instrumentation is a important subject and is totally deals with the measuring part or measuring components or measuring the value in the instrument, in the basically power system. So we can say the power system instrumentation is dealing with the measuring quantity of power system. We can easily measure the power system quantities, for example voltage, current, impedance, we can say power, energy, all these we can easily measure, but for the measurement of them we need a instrument. So if I am talking about that instrument in the power system, that comes in the power system instrumentation. So it is basically an important subject, or we can see the extended or the enhanced part of the electrical measurement and electronic measurement or electrical measuring instruments, we can say EMI or EM. And basically this is the extension part I am seeing here. So it means in electrical measurement we talked about the measuring instrument which is for the electrical quantity. So similar to that we having the measuring instrument, but some electronic instrument we have, and we are basically talking about the high power. They basically measure the low power, low voltage, low current, but I am talking about the high power, high voltage and high current. So we need what? We need a certain instruments, certain things. So that things we are going to cover in this power system instrumentation, and we lot of we covered because we are at the unit number 5, and unit 5 is the last unit as per the our curriculum. So if I am talking about the unit number 1, so in unit number 1 we have studied about the errors. So errors is just similar to the blunders and mistake made by the human being, because we are a human being, not a god, so we make blunders and mistakes. So similar to that, a instrument having the errors in it. So what are the errors? These errors are such as random, gross, systematical, environmental, parallax, and all these errors we have. And basically these errors affected the accuracy of the instrument. Now accuracy is the word which is come from accurate. Accurate means we can say the true value. So true value, for example, I am having a true value. If I want to measure a voltage in a circuit, the value will be 5 volt. That is the true value. But I am not getting the 5 value. I am getting the repetition of readings nearby to 5, that is 4.7, 4.6, 4.8, 4.8, 4.9, 4.7, 4.8, again and again. So if I am getting these value, means I am getting the precision. That is the repetition of readings, known as repetition of measurement, repeatability of measurement. That is known as what? That is known as basically the precision. So accuracy and precision both are there. If we having several measurements in the measurement, so what we have to do? We have to calculate the errors basically. So how we calculate? First we take the mean. First we take what? Mean. How we can take a mean? If 8 readings are there, do add all 8 readings, all measurement, and divide by 8. Divide by 8. So we get what? We get what, my dear student? We will get the mean, average. And if I want to take the deviation, so the average will be the 4. For example, the average will be the 4.6. But I am getting the value 4.5 and then 4.8, 4.9. So I am having the deviation, positive side and the negative side in the average. So we make a curve of this error. So that curve is known as the distribution curve, and also known as the Gaussian distribution curve. So we can identify the deviation is from the negative side, it's from the positive side. So we can identify the range, that the range having the positive side are more or the negative sides are more. So we can identify it easily with the help of that Gaussian curve or the normal distribution of the Gaussian curve. Then we can calculate the deviations. We take the average of it, that we can call as average deviation. Standard deviation is also there, similar to that your in mathematics we have studied about the statistical theory, how can we solve the so many readings. So that is the standard deviation we have. Then we having the variance. So these all are in the unit number 1. Now if I am talking about the unit number 2, my dear student, so unit number 2 is basically what is basically telling you about or told you about the instrument or a device or an element or a particle of a system which basically use to convert or basically conversion from one form of energy to the another. So if I am talking about the one form to the another, so the one form may be the physical quantities. Now if I am talking about the physical quantity, though maybe the acoustic, chemical, biological, displacement, pressure, mechanical energy, okay, we having the we can say the force is there, so we can convert into the electrical, because I am an electrical engineer and you are an electrical engineering student and we are studying this subject in the electrical engineering branch. So we always talk about the electrical transducer in a power system. So electrical transducer what it does convert one form of energy to the electrical energy, that is electrical transducer, so known as electrical transducer. So in electrical transducer we having two conditions, we having two basically the part. First is your the sensor, second is the transducer. So sensor basically senses this type of reading we have, and transduction is basically transduce change or convert into the another. So transduction, if I am talking about, though we having so many characteristics which the basically the transducer having it in it, okay, then we having the transducer on the basis primary and secondary, active and passive, analog and digital. On the basis of transduction we having capacitive, inductive, magnetic, photoconductive, photovoltaic, phototransductive. So all these we have. In this we having different transducer. For example, we have understood about the LVDT, that is linear variable differential transducer. Okay, then we having the RVDT, rotary basically. Then we having the thermistor, the thermal resistance we can. Then we having the RTD, that is resistance temperature detector. Then we having the potentiometer, that is POT, POT, POT you can say. Strain gauges we are applying. Okay, and Seebeck effect, that is thermocouple. Then we having what, piezoelectric transducer, photovoltaic cell, okay, capacitive in transducer we have, magnetic measurement we having, Hall effect. So we have understood so many transducer for the different measurement. We having the another transducer known as inverse transducer. Inverse transducer do what, if we apply voltage on it, electrical on it, it convert into another form. Similar to that we having the piezoelectric crystal. If I am applying the force on it, then it will directly convert to the voltage, and if I am applying voltage on it, it changes its dimension, that is displacement. So the basic example is thermometer, you can say. So RTD we have, LVDT we have, thermistor we have, thermocouple we have, potentiometer we have, resistance temperature detector we have, thermistor we have, strain gauges we have, thermocouple we have, photovoltaic cell we have, magnetic field we have, Hall effect we have. So many we can say the transducer we have for the measurement purpose. So we have understood all this. Then in the unit number 3, basically signal condition. So if I am talking about the signal condition, my dear student, so if I am in a signal condition, I want to condition the signal, so I need sensor and I need a transducer also. So transducer is a main component that thing. Then we need a amplifier. So in amplifier we use first amplifier, that is the operational amplifier, that is IC741, 8 pin structure. In this 8 pin structure, all 5 pins are in the use for inverting, non-inverting inputs, one output and two voltages, negative and positive, and 3 are for the for 2 for the no connection, 1 for the null side. So I hope you understand. Okay, in IC741, that is known as operational amplifier. That operational amplifier is known by its working. Basically, why I am telling it is an amplifier. Amplifier do what? Amplify the signal. Means in high input impedance and low output impedance. So that having in the operational amplifier, gain is very high, and having the good sensitivity, high rejection to CMMR, common mode rejection, you can say. Rejection we having, rejection ratio, that is common mode rejection ratio. We having this all in this, and basically why I am telling it is a operation, because it performs several mathematical operations. For example, we have mathematical operation like adder, subtractor, differentiator, integrator, logarithmic, anti-logarithmic, voltage follower, difference we can get from it, inverting output we are getting from it, negative, that is. So several mathematical operations perform this, that is why it is known as operational amplifier. So that is IC741. Then we having the instrumentational amplifier. While we are using in the instrument, so that is the instrumentational amplifier. That instrumentational amplifier is basically what? Is basically the combination of three op amps. One is the differential, another one, two are giving the same input, and differential do this. Then we have the isolation amplifier. Isolation amplifier to isolate, if I am connecting the amplifier and the electronic component or the measuring instrument or the, we can say, nowadays we are using in the laboratory so many instruments for measurement, the pulse rate, heartbeat, high blood pressure, sugar, and all these things. We need a electronic equipment that is totally based on the electrical supply. So if there is no isolation, then what will happen? The leakage current will flow to the patient body and it will affect it. Electric shock will be there. And though we have to make electrical safety, so for this we need isolation amplifier. Okay. Then we having the optocoupler, analog multiplier and divider, Gilbert mixer we have used, Gilbert mathematics we are using. Function generator, we can generate three different types of waves: triangular, sinusoidal, rectangular, and sawtooth leakage. So we use what? We use op amp, operational amplifier, as the integrator. Again, if I'm talking about the analog multiplier and divider, and we can say adder and subtractor. In adder and subtractor, we are again using op amp. In analog multiplier, subtractor, we are using Gilbert mixer. If I'm talking about the optical amplifier, we having the optocoupler or optical amplifier, we use again integrator, op amp is there, and we having two things, frequency and power, we can see. So we having all this thing, then we having frequency to voltage converter, again using frequency path and the voltage path. Then we having the temperature to voltage converter, we can directly do this thing with the help of proposed TVC there, but we can say the temperature to current converter. We have studied a lot about this thing, basically. Then we having what? We having a basically grounding and shielding. Grounding is again a very important part. Why it is a very important part? Because if I having a leakage current, means fault in it, so leakage current will always flow into the path where having the load impedance, similar to ourselves. If I want to drive a car and want to go to the destination, reach to the destination, so I have to follow that path in which I will find less or low red lights, we can say, or low hurdles, speed breakers, and all these things. Okay, so I have to follow that path. So similar to that, the leakage current will always follow that path in which the low impedance we have. So we have to produce low impedance. So how can we do? We can say the star to delta connections in a transformer. So three phase, four wire, we can say. So three wires are connected to the three phase and remaining wire is connected to the ground for this leakage current path, we can say. Okay, I hope you understand. Then we having the shielding and grounding. We having two types, multiple point and single point. In single point, we connect all the instruments grounding into the single point. For example, I am having 19 equipments. Connect all the 19 equipments grounding at the single point. Then we have the multi-point, means all 19 instruments having their separate ourselves grounding. It is known as multiple point grounding. Then we having the shielding to protect the instrument. In copper, we always having a shielding part. So all metals having the shielding and permeability. So we talked a lot. We have understood about a lot about the unit number three, that is signal conditioning. Then we having the unit number, we can say what? Unit number four. In unit number four, we have understood about the measurement of voltage and current. So it is very easy. We can measure the voltage with the help of voltmeter and with the help of ammeter. So voltmeter always connect in the parallel in the circuit from which we have to measure it. And we connect the ammeter in the series. Voltmeter in the parallel or ammeter in the series. And we having the loading effects. For example, if I am connecting a voltmeter measuring instrument, a meter measuring instrument, so both having their internal resistance. So their internal resistance always produce a disturbance or effect on the reading. So that is known as loading effect. It is known as what? Loading effect. Though we having two types of instrument, analog and digital. If I'm talking about the analog, though we having the full scale deflection, reflecting torque, controlling torque and a scale. But if I'm talking about the digital, though we having binary language and some solid state components, means electronic components. Okay, so this is all about the voltmeter, ammeter. Then we having the, we can say, measurement of voltage, frequency, voltage, time delay and frequency and phase interrupt. So CRO is the best instrument or equipment for this. In CRO, it is also known as cathode ray oscilloscope. In this cathode ray oscilloscope, the hood, or we can say the main component, is CRT. And with the CRT, in the CRT, we having the cathode gun, you can say, and heater which through which we having the cathode gun. Then we having the focusing anode and the aligning anode. Then we having the horizontal plate and the vertical plate, through which the ions basically placed on the iron, just like a fire placed on a scope. That is a, we can say, screen. So it gives you the wave, it gives you the output. So similar to that, we can found the output in the LCD screen, that is of CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope. So from the waves, we can identify the voltages at horizontal or vertical level. We can identify the time from the scale. If I am identifying the time, though, we can identify the frequency, that is F is proportional to 1 upon T. If I am getting the two waves, so the difference of two waves is the phase difference. So we can identify the phase. So with the help of CRO and the Saju's figure, we can identify the frequency, we can identify the voltage, we can identify the phase angle, and we can identify the time. If time is there, we can easily identify or measure the frequency. And if we are measuring the frequency, we can identify the time. I hope you understand. Then we having the active and reactive and apparent power, that is complex power, we can measure it. Then we having the energy meter. So energy meter we are using for what? It's also known as watt hour meter, for the measurement of energy. Though it is an induction type, or we can say disc type structure, seven types we have. Then we having the, that is known as analog. Then we having the basically digital, or we can say electronic. In digital electronic, we having so many electronic components we use, microprocessor base and all these. So we can do this, the measurement. Similar to that, we having the special type like energy meter, that having the storage capacity. We can use for the tariff meter also. We can directly calculate the tariff in the form A plus B and C, constant and B part and E part. So we can easily measure with the help of these, the tariff meters. Okay, so these are the tariff meters we have understood in the unit number 4. Now in unit number 5, we having basically the power system instrumentation number 2. The unit 4 is the power system instrumentation number 1. So basically we are coming into the power system instrumentation part. So in the power system instrumentation part, we are going to study the first part, that is instrument transformers. So what are they? We are going to understand. Now if I am starting this unit, my dear student, so there will be some objective of myself. I have a motto to accomplish that motto, to accomplish my task. So I have some objectives. So my first objective is help the learner, means you students, to understand the basics of instrument transformers. What do you mean by instrument transformer? Why we are using this? Which type of instrument transformer we have? So all these we are going to cover it. So help the learner or students to understand the basics of instrument transformers. Now understand the detailed theory of current transformer. So instrument transformer are classified into two categories. One is the current transformer, this measures the current. Another one is the potential transformer, for the voltage and potential. So basically I am considering a current transformer. I am delivering this lecture on the instrument transformer basics and the theory of current transformer. This type of current transformer we have, how can we use it, where we can place it. So all these we are going to study. Now moving forward, instrument transformer. So the pictures or the images I am showing you here, I am showing you, do you, my dear students. So all these are basically the instrument transformer. We can find a voltage transformer, we can find a capacitive voltage transformer, we can find a current transformer in it. So these are the some images. What are the instrument transformers we have? So in this we are showing you the disc type, we are showing you the different types instrument transformer, which you have already studied in the SGP. Basically instrument transformer we having in the EMI also, but in this we having the little part or the small part, that is instrument transformer. So these all are the instrument transformer with bushings and all. So here are the some images. Now instrument transformer, What is an instrument transformer? What is an instrument transformer? So it is a transformer that is used in conjunction with any measuring instrument, that is ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter, watt-hour meter, etc. Many measuring instruments or protective equipment, that is relay. It utilizes the current transformation and voltage transformer properties, or we can say the properties of the transformer, that is the transformation ratio, to measure high AC current and voltage. So we can say instrument transformer we are using to measure high voltage and current, because ammeter and voltmeter having certain limitations. Now, for example, a voltmeter maximum we can use for the 220 volt measurement. So if I want to measure the voltage in kilo, means 10 raised to the power 3, 1000 volt, 1000 watt, 1000, we can say 1000 ampere, 1000 volt, 1000 watt. So if I have to measure all these quantity, though voltmeter, wattmeter, a simple voltmeter, wattmeter, ammeter is not sufficient. So I need a different different instrument known as instrument transformer. And this is used in the conjunction with measuring instrument, ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter, watt-hour meter, etc. Or protective equipment's relay. Relay is just like a switch, which is used for the protection purpose. So it utilizes the current transformation, obviously. How we are using the current transformation now? See, in a transformer, we having K, that is transformation ratio, is always equal to the ratio of secondary voltage to the primary voltage, primary current to the secondary current, we can say, and primary turns to secondary turns to the primary turns. So V2 I2 is equals to V1 I1. So we can say V2 by V1 is equals to I1 by I2 is equals to N2 by N1. That is your key transformation ratio. So by using transformation, current transformation, by using voltage transformation. Now see, if I want to step down the current, so which configuration I have to use? That is step up. Why step up? Because in a step up, the secondary voltage is increasing, is uplifting, but the decreasing of the current of secondary side. The secondary side or basically the output current is decreasing. That is I2. So I2 is decreasing means step down. So I have to use step up construction. Step up means secondary winding having more turns and primary winding having few turns. So in current transformer, we apply this thing. If I'm talking about the voltage measurement, that is potential transformer and voltage transformer. So in voltage transformer, I need step down transformer. So step down, we having primary turns are more compared to the secondary turns. So we apply these transformers. I hope you understand. Now, instrument transformers. The types of instrument transformers are, these instrument transformers are of two types. As I earlier told you, we basically considered for two main things, voltage and current. Because we know, if I want to know the power, then we need voltage and current. Okay. If I want to know the impedance, then we need voltage and current. If I want to know the reactance, capacitance, inductance, resistance, admittance, we need voltage and current. In both cases, we are in the need of voltage and current. So respect to that, or we can say, considering all these things, we having current transformer and potential transformer. I hope you understand. Current transformers and potential transformer. As name suggested, current transformer for the measurement of current, and voltage transformer is using for the measurement of voltage. Now moving forward, application of instrument transformers. Now for measurement of high AC current, it is usual to use low range AC ammeter with suitable shunt. For measurement of high AC current, that is of high rating, kilo amperes we can say, because if I am talking kilo volt, then it means the corresponding current will be kilo ampere. So for measurement of high AC current, it is usual to use low range AC ammeter with suitable shunt. For measurement of high AC voltage, low range AC voltmeters are used with the high resistance connected in series. In voltmeter, we connected resistance series. In ammeter, we connect resistance in parallel. For measurement of very high AC current and voltage, we cannot use this method. Instead, we use specially constructed high voltage instrument transformer to insulate the high voltage circuit from the measuring circuit in order to protect the measuring instruments from burning. Otherwise, burning takes place, because high voltage will flow means high current will flow, and high current will flow, that high high copper loss or the power loss we have, that will burn the instrument. So for the measuring, we can say to protect the amazing instrument. From burning, we have to do this. So the application is high AC current and high AC voltage. Application of instrumentation transformers, or we can say the instrument transformer, in DC circuit for current and voltage measurement, we use low range DC ammeter and voltmeters with rectifiers connected in their secondary circuit, because transformer always work on AC, not on DC. So we can't able to get DC output from the transformer. So if I want to get the DC output of the transformer, we have to use rectifiers. So that rectifiers will basically convert the output of transformer, that is AC, into DC, and we use low range DC ammeter and voltmeter corresponding to their secondary point. Okay, with rectifiers connected in their secondary circuit. The vast primary application of instrument transformer is for the production and control of power system and power equipment of high and very high ratings. We can't able to measure the high ratings or high voltage and high current ratings. So they basically protect and control our power system. So they basically, the instrument transformer serving two things here, serving two activities, serves two things here. There, one is basically the production, another one is the measurement. So control of power system and the production and measurement also. So the working of these instrument transformer are similar to that those of ordinary transformer, as I earlier told you, but we use for the measurement purpose. That is what is known as instrument transformer. Now see here, instrument transformer is similar to that your simple transformer. Now the basic conception magnetic circuit of instrument transformer, it is similar to that your simple transformer. Now see, that is the primary winding, we having H1 and H2, secondary winding X1 and X2, we having the primary winding resistance R1, reactance X1, secondary winding resistance R2 and reactance X2. If I'm making the equivalent circuit, and if we give supply to the primary and connected load to the secondary, so in the secondary we always connect the ammeter or voltmeter. If I am connecting the voltmeter, though, we connect a voltmeter in the parallel and ammeter in the series for measurement of voltage and current. And the working is similar to that your transformer, that is the Faraday law of an electromagnetic induction, in which we give supply to the primary side. The corresponding to that supply, we having the induced flux in it. That flux is in the nature of the basically supply current, that is of alternating. So it moves and cut the secondary winding and induce an EMF in it, as per the Faraday law of an electromagnetic induction. And we having the two windings in it, known as primary and secondary. Generally, we give supply to the primary. So primary always connected in the system and secondary connected with the meters. Okay. And similar to that, we having the ferromagnetic material core, we having the lamination on it, and the core is basically for the magnetic flux and magnetic flux path. So we having the core in it, and we having the, first we give the supply to the coil, then the supply meet current meet with the turns, so we can get MMF and reluctance in this core. Though MMF by reluctance, we having the flux. That flux is in the nature of alternating, because we are giving alternating supply to the primary side. The alternating flux is in the of moving nature. It moves and flow in the basically move in a core, similar to that moving in a core, and cut by the secondary winding of the core and induce an EMF as per the Faraday law of an electromagnetic induction or mutual induction, we can say. So basic construction and magnetic circuit of instrument transformer is this. Now we can say the instrument transformer, polarity of instrument transformer are C like this. We having H1 input, X1 for the output, that is secondary side. So H1 is there and X1 is there. Similar to that, we having the core representation with the two parallel lines, always show the magnetic path, that is core. That is what? Always you will find two parallel lines in a core, in a transformer, between the winding. Why we found this? Because this is the representation of magnetic path of flux, that is core. That is what? That is your core. Basically, it is a core. So primary and secondary, which in between we having the core. So one thing is there in a transformer, that all windings are connected in a single core, on a single core, in two limbs, or we can say the center limb, or in the two limbs. Core, we having core type transformer, that is used for the high power application, and shell type for the low power application. So if I am using the measuring, though, we can use core type instrument, core type transformer. Though in core, basically the two windings are connected or bound on the two limbs. And if I'm talking about the wounded on the two limbs, basically it means what? We can say a series circuit is there, series magnetic circuit. But if I'm talking about the shell type, doing shell type, we having the middle limb, so winding is wounded on the middle limb, so having the parallel magnetic circuit. And we having the two windows in it. And if I'm talking about the basically the core type, we having the single window. But in this, the coils are electrically separated and magnetically coupled. So the magnetic path is same, but the electrical connections are different. Different for primary, different from secondary. So I hope you understand. Now, this is the common connection of instrument transformer. Now see here, starting from here, we having the line voltage. This is your primary polarity, and this is the secondary of voltage transformer. Because voltage transformer always connect in a parallel. If I want to measure the voltage, so voltmeter always connect in the across, like this. If circuit is this, we connect like this. But if I have ammeter is this, so we connect like this, means series. So if I'm if I want to show here, though it is a line voltage, so we having the polarity, so we connect primary here, and corresponding to that we having the secondary, and we have connected parallelly a voltmeter, and then we having the protection relay grounded here, then we having the watt hour meter, that is energy meter, to give the voltage from it. And similar to that, if we want to measure the current with the help of current transformer, because voltage transformer always we are using for the voltage measurement, and current transformer we are using for the current measurement. So current transformer is connecting in a series here. It is in a series, and we having the primary and the secondary polarity, and secondary is connected with the ammeter and protection relay and giving input to the watt hour meter. So voltage we are getting from the voltmeter, potentiometer, or we can say the potential meter. PT, we also say that it is a potentiometer, and we can also say that it is a VT, that is voltage transformer, and potential transformer, that is PT, and the potential measurement, we can say the potential meter, I'm saying, but it is a potential transformer, and we can say the voltage transformer used for the measurement of voltage. So voltage measurement we can do with the help of the parallel connection, and current we can measure with the help of series connection, and we are giving to the watt hour meter for the calculation of the power, that is V into I. So we are getting V from the potential transformer and I from the ampere transformer, basically the current transformer, and relay we are using in the position. So that is the basic layout or a simple diagram of instrument transformer for understanding. Okay, so in voltage transformer we short circuit with the voltmeter, and in current also we open circuit with the help of ammeter. Okay, so if I am talking about the voltage transformer, though it means I am stepping down the voltage. So stepping down the voltage means we use step down transformer, means the turns of primary is basically higher or having the large number compared to the secondary winding. Means secondary winding turns having low number or less number compared to the primary. So I hope you understand. Now these are the substation class circuit breakers. Substation class, now these are the circuit breakers. See, these are the, we can say, circuit breakers CTs, current transformers. We having the substation class circuit breakers, SF6 or so many things we having, air blast, SF6, vacuum. Okay, SF6 is the gas circuit breaker, we can say. Oil circuit breaker we having, air blast circuit breaker we having, vacuum circuit breaker we having. The SF6 circuit breaker is very good, having the good advantage over all these. So it is showing you the substation class circuit breaker CT. So it is a CT, and it is in the basically a bundle of a wire. It look like a ring shape we have in CT. It look like a bundle of a wire, because you are if you try to purchase a wire, so you always get a wire in the form of bundle. Meters we can identify in the measurement, that is in the meters. You can see, you can find it in a meters. So I hope you understand about this thing. Now CT, what is CT? CT is the basically turn ratio. What is it? It basically the turn ratio. So turn ratio is given by the primary current / secondary current. Now obviously if I'm talking about the one thing is there, my dear student, that the CT is the current transformer, and current transformer always having the construction similar to the step up transformer, because in step up transformer the primary winding voltage is higher, is lesser compared to the secondary winding voltage, but the primary winding current is higher compared to the secondary winding current. So we want to stepping down the current but stepping up the voltage. So for this, the transformation ratio is a ratio between primary current of the CT to the secondary current of the CT. So for example, primary current will be the higher 100 amps, that is 100 ampere. And if I'm talking about the secondary current, that will be the 5 ampere. So the ratio will be 100 by 5, 100 is to 5, 20 is to 1. Means the ratio will be 20 is to 1, that is CT ratio, or we can say the CT turn ratio. Primary current to the secondary current. Primary current always having the higher value, and secondary current always having the lower value, because it is step up construction, but as per the current, we can say it is a step down construction. Because in step up construction, voltage is higher, current is lower. In step down construction, voltage is lower, but current is higher. So I hope you understand about this turn ratio. Polarity. So if I want to identify the polarity, my dear student, so polarity will be given like this. The direction of current will always show like this arrow. The direction of the secondary current is this. This is the secondary point. This is the primary point. And Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineer, that is IEEE and IEC, secondary polarity marks, that is X1, X1. So we always use, as per the IEEE on IEC, X1 for secondary. X1 is for the secondary. Basically, it is S1 for secondary. But as per the polarity marks given by the IEEE and IEC, because we have to follow that one, they are the basically a governing body, or we can say the statutory body, which gives you the how can we follow the things in electrical and electronics engineering. So they make X1 for the secondary and H1 for the primary. So primary polarity marks given by IEEE and IEC, that is H1, and X1 and S1 is for the secondary side, that is given by the IEEE. So that is secondary polarity marks. Primary current into polarity forces, secondary current out of polarity forces. Now primary current into the polarity forces, it is into the C, and secondary is out of the polarity. It is out of the, we can say the primary is in the, and secondary is out of. So we can say out of secondary, in inner, we have in the primary. So primary current into the polarity forces and secondary current out of the polarity. So I hope you understand about this thing. Now again, I am showing you here, polarity current into non-polarity forces, secondary current out of the non-polarity. So see here, again direction of the secondary current. So we have in the IEEE and IEC, that is second polarity marks, and primary polarity, that is IEC. So here, direction of the primary current. See, it is the direction of primary current input, so output of the polarity of secondary. So primary current into non-polarity forces, we have the outer, and secondary current out of the non-polarity forces. You can see. So try to understand what this diagram want to tell you and what I want to show you here, my dear student, through this diagram. So here we are having the primary current into the non-polarity forces and secondary current out of the non-polarity forces. And it is a ring structured CT. We have different types of CT. So that is a ring structure. Now, CT metering accuracy. Since actual secondary current is not equal to the rated secondary current, then the difference in percentage is known as accuracy or class of CT. Actual secondary current, for example, we are getting 55 kilo ampere, but the rated secondary current is 10 kilo ampere. So 5 is equal to 10, not equal to that. Then it is the difference in percentage known as, if I take the difference, for example, 5 by 10, I'm getting 50%. So 50% known as the accuracy or class of the CT. So CT metering accuracy. We can identify also, we can try to remember, or we want to express that what is CT metering accuracy. So CT metering accuracy is showing by this equation, that is, since actual secondary current, I gave an example you, that is the, for example, 5 kilo ampere, and the rated secondary current will be 10 kilo ampere. So if 5 kilo ampere is not equal to the 10 kilo ampere, though we can say the difference, that is the 50%, is known as the accuracy, or we can say class of current transformer. That is what a class of transformer. I hope you understand. Now burden is basically denoted as a load. For example, I have to you means you are a student and I am teaching you this subject, and the burden for you, my dear student, to understand this thing and understand this thing and give the exam and try to score 100% marks, try to score 90% marks. दैट उसको 95% मार्क्स, दैट उसको 98% मार्क्स. सो दीज ऑल आर बेसिकली बर्डन फॉर यू. सो सिमिलर टू दैट द लोड कनेक्टेड टू द सिटी सेकेंडरी इट्स नोन एज बर्डन. बर्डन सिटी बर्डन द लोड कनेक्टेड टू द सेकेंडरी नोन एज बर्डन इंक्लूड्स डिवाइसेज एंड कनेक्टिंग लूप्स. Includes devices, the devices we are connecting with the in the CT secondary, and the connecting leads we are connecting leads we have. So express always expressed in ohms, always expressed in ohms. So standard values we have B naught, burden 0.1, burden 0.2, burden 0.5, burden 0.9, burden 1.8, E, we can say 0.04, 0.2. So we having some standard values. We can say the burden is showing you the some standard value here, and these are the basically load connected to the CT secondary. If I am talking about the load connected to the CT secondary, means these are the burden for it. Similar to that, you student, you have to study hard and give the exam and secure good marks. That is a burden for you. If you are in the job, so you have to achieve the target, you have to accomplish your project in the certified or the specified time. That is a burden for me. So similar to that, the load connected, the form the load connected and the load connected to CT secondary is burden for it. That is CT burden, known as CT burden. Includes devices and connecting leads, expressed it always in ohms. The standard values we have B.1, B.2, burden 0.2, burden 0.2, burden 0.1, burden 0.2, burden 0.5, burden 0.9, and we can say burden 1.8 and E.04. And E.2. So these are the burden. I hope you understand. Now, CT accurate burden calculation. How can we identify? See here, 1 ohm is connected here and 2 ohm is there. So ZT is equals to RCT plus RL plus ZT. Now, what is RCT? What is RL? What is ZB? So ZT is the total burden in the ohms, vector summation of the resistance and inductance components. CT is secondary resistance in ohms at 75 degrees centigrade. So maximum temperature we have in 75 degree centigrade because there will be some temperature rise will be there. So CT secondary resistance in ohms at 75 degree centigrade. RL is the resistance of lead in ohms because we are calculating the burden. So lead is there. So of leads in ohm, total loop distance that is given here 2 ohm. That is 2 ohm we have. And device impedance in ohm. That is what device impedance in ohm. So that is ZT is equal to RCT plus RL plus ZB. I hope you understand. Now CT saturation. The factor affecting degree and time to saturation, that is high DC offset, high fall current magnitude, symmetrical current. Example 100 to 5 CT means at 20 times, so 2000 amperes. Also at 2000 amperes, we have 200 times CT. So low CT turn ratio, high secondary burden, low CT accuracy class, high remanence flux can occur if current interrupted when core is saturated. If DC flows in our winding during testing, we can say need a voltage above 60% of knee point to reduce the remanence to less than 10% of the saturation flux density. So these are the factors affecting degree and time to saturation. I hope you understand. Tips for avoiding saturation, use higher ratio CTs, always higher, not low ratio CT. Use separate set of high ratio CTs for high fault current ripple. Reduce secondary burden by selecting low burden relays and meters, disturbing single phase burdens among phases, increasing the size of secondary leads, reducing the length of secondary leads, leads reducing, you can say, using step down auxiliary CTs. So we can do with the help of this. Now moving forward, this is the CT saturation curve with linear operation, knee limit of the curve. So we are having the saturation, see here, below the line 60 current, above the line the voltage. It is showing you the knee point, higher and lower. Okay, I hope you understand. Then the typical window CT we having CT actual condition. Now see here, it is connected in the board, we can say the electric board and the supply. We having the system, that is the CT actual condition. Typical window CT we are having. So we having H1 and X1 means primary and secondary. Now power transformer CT connection. So we having the power transformer, we connect CT in this point here for the current measurement. So slip over current transformer. Slip over current transformer to for installation over exterior of the outdoor bushing. We're having bushings on the power transformer, so we place CT there. So for the current measurement, low voltage and high voltage. So outdoor type B burden 02 for retrofit we have. similar to that. Then we having ground shield like this for circuit breaker CT, substation class circuit breaker we having, and we having the ring structure of window CT we place here for the current measurement. That is ground shield. And outdoor B naught buttons or 7 replace BCT in shield aluminium housing. So we are using ground shield instead of others. Generator CT connection we are placing like this in the phases. Generator CT like this. Okay. Now, I hope you understand about the these current transformer and the potential transformer. A little bit potential transformer and more about current transformer. So related to that, we having some MCQs, multiple choice question. What is a current transformer? A transformer used with an AC ammeter, a transformer used with an DC ammeter, a transformer used with an AC voltmeter, a transformer used with an DC voltmeter. For example, we are saying it is a current transformer, so it always use ammeter. So option is A, AC. What is potential transformer? A transformer used with DC ammeter with AC voltmeter, with DC ammeter with AC with an AC voltmeter. So the option is B. Option is B. Now, CT and PT are used for what? Measuring low current and voltages, measuring very low current and voltage, measuring high current and voltage, measuring intermediate current and voltage. So high current, option C. The primary winding of CT has, if I am telling you that it is a step up conception, so less turn, few turns. So option is D. The secondary winding has of a site CT has obviously maximum turns. So a large number of turns, option B. The turn ratio for a CT is NP by NS, NS by NP, 1 by NP, N is equals to NS only. So option is secondary to the primary, that is NS by NP. The primary winding of a PT, potential transformer. So as I earlier told you, the potential transformer is the similar construction to the step down transformer. The primary winding having higher, large number of turns. So option is a large number of turns, that is C. Secondary winding of PT has step down, few turns. So a few turns, option D. The turn ratio for PT, not for CT, that is NP by primary to secondary, NP by NS. How is frequency related to the time period? So square proportional, not related, directly proportional, inversely proportional. Obviously, F is inversely proportional to the T. So we can say 1 by T. So inversely proportional, option is T. So these are the reference books from which I took some material to deliver this lecture. The Dhanpat Rai Sons book, that is A.K. Sahni, is a very good book. It's, we can say, the Bible by the Indian author for measuring instrument or measurement. Rajesh Prasad Khanna is, or Rajesh Prasad from Khanna Publishers, is also a very good book. You can just refer it, having a good content. A.S. Morris, again, having a good content from an international author. So these are very good books. You can refer it. These are available in our library. Now, thank you from my side. I hope you understand about this instrument transformer. So this is the one part of instrument transformer. Then we have the second part, that is the potential transformer. So later on, I'll tell you about the potential transformer. I hope you understand this thing. So this is all about from my side. I hope you.